Ish Paints very early gave me extremely challenging roles. My first role was being a sales HR manager for the West Division, but it was not just about the sales HR responsibilities. I also had central responsibilities for the whole organization, including compensation and learning and development. So it just gives a lot of responsibility very early on, and you're supposed to deliver. So that's the best way that one stretches oneself and sort of figures out what one can or cannot do. Even the next role was around mergers and acquisitions in the country, and we did two large acquisitions, of which the entire integration journey I was a part of. So that's one thing good about Asian Paints, that it has something which is challenging for every single person who joins. The other piece that Asian Paints really helps in is it has a very strong peer group, and when you have a good peer group, there is a lot of learning that even comes from discussions with peers. So again, a lot of companies boast about it, but what differentiates Asian Paints is that we have very low attrition. So across the years, we have had single digit attrition, and most of our leaders have spent 20 years plus in the organization. So you have a kind of wealth of internal information, which is not very easily available in a lot of other organizations. And because we are market leaders, and we have been market leaders for the last 40 years now, 1968 to 2018 now, it gives a lot of confidence of experimenting and being willing to try out new ideas and going with that. If we were in an organization where day-to-day business was a struggle, then the actual challenges would be very different. Whereas Asian Paints sort of gives that opportunity to sort of experiment with new concepts, and that's, I think, great for one's career, because it gives that wealth of exposure which one may or may not get in another organization.
There were a lot of things that actually the organization did right from our induction to the whole leap stint that we have. We had different stints, we had plant stints, sales stints, that ensured that we get a thorough overview of the organization. But one of the major things that the organization does to you that actually ensures that you're on a path to success is the amount of freedom and, you know, ownership of work that they give you. Such amount of ownership, usually when I talk to my peers, is not experienced in any other organization. So that is one major difference that was witnessed by me here at Asian Paints.
The most crucial thing here, I think, is the value that's given to feedback. Throughout my training program, as well as once I got confirmed and I got this role, there's been a lot of feedback given to me, both positive as well as things that are supposed to help me out, saying, you know, why don't you think of doing this in another way? So sure, you've come up with this initiative, but why don't you think through it a little more and see what exactly you're targeting? Is this the right thing that you're doing? So it really forces you to think through a lot of work that you're doing, and finally at the end of the day, it turns out that you come up with work with a lot of value, which helps you feel connected to your job and to the workplace. That's one thing. And the second thing is the ownership. So if it really entrusts you with a lot of responsibilities, it says, okay, you know, you want to do it, go right ahead. Just ensure that you know what you're doing at every step and hold it all together. So I think these two are really, really important things that Asian Paints does.
The very first thing that Asian Paints did, so to put me on a path to success, was that it tried to bring me out of the comfort zone of the college or that environment that existed before it. We are in a very safe environment in the college. Asian Paints pushes you to the extreme, and it does it by not putting you into a familiar environment. While I know that many other companies would try to put you in a location where language is not a language would not be a problem, and being in a sales role, you have to interact with dealers, you have to interact with contractors in the local language. So what Asian Paints does very well is it would try to send you as far as away from your home location into a place where you would not know the local language, you would not know the local customs, you would not know how things are done at that place. And it lets you explore and try to find out ways. Sure, a lot of us had faced problems with it, but then there was always support from the company, but you were always asked and supposed to find out a way of doing this work. So just to give you an example, I was sent to Bangalore, I was sent to Karnataka, and I was supposed to interact with local contractors, painters, and people who would not understand Hindi or English. And the first 2 weeks were very bad. You could not make a connection with them. But then once you try to understand those small words or, you know, gestures and something. So yeah, and then it's sort of eased off after that. And then Now, I'm very proud to say I can be sent to any part of the country and I won't feel any kind of discomfort in trying to communicate with the people or trying to interact with them. Another thing that Asian Pains did very well was the Asian Pains Leap program, which is the induction program for us, for the training program, it's very well planned. You have reviews, you have assessments at every stage. You would not even know that it's a review happening. You'll be given constant feedback throughout. The kind of hierarchical system that there is in terms of reviews, you will have a friend in your mentor, in the person you're reporting to, and you can go and talk to him about anything and everything. And I think that really helps you when you start off a career in the company.